Guten Tag and welcome back everybody to Modded Minecraft 1.10 with yours truly, Buster. Hey, hey, how are you doing, guys? I hope you had a great weekend. Mine was actually not that great because of bees. Man, I can't stand bees anymore. I wasted the whole Thursday, 8 hours, another 4 on Friday because I wanted to make a video about it. And guess what? The stupid beans don't work with me. Wintry princess. A wintry princess. A wintry princess. And a wintry princess. It does not work. So I think something along the lines of 12 hours. Trying to breed a common bee. A brie, yes, a brie is at least delicious. A common bee from hive bees. And apparently they have a chance to breed of 15%. I think that is more something like along the lines of 0.015%, something. Yeah, so I need distance from bees. And as you can tell, things changed a bit, actually. So first of all, I expanded the base here. It was following the side of the cliff originally. And I decided to go over in a straight line. This here is the old line we had before. And from here on, we were zigzagging back to there. And I just made it straight over to there. Good, so we have now more room inside, and you can see there is still the cliff inside that has to go, of course. But and that is not our concern for today. We can look at it. There we go. And behind here is all the stuff from refined storage. So we have to find a solution what we want to do with that. Maybe just close it in here and have a corner in the room, something like that. I haven't decided yet, but I want to look finally into base building. I tore down the whole building, as you can tell. There was just this rather ugly walls with nothing inside, not even the roof, not even proper walls. So I was thinking, and this was my intention all along, to create a building here on top of this here, mainly for immersive engineering, because I think immersive engineering is one of the most beautiful themed mods. We have all this nice apparatus, I have no clue, machines, and they really look very, very awesome, and they look industrial. And they look actually big. When you think about a regular furnace, is exactly that size. And this furnace here is rather really monster compared to that. So we want to have something that that shows off this nice mod. And we have so many things here. We have all these coke ovens. We have the blast furnaces, we have the electric arc furnace, I think. We have this here, we have diesel generators, we have so many things, and they all look awesome. And we have no place to play around with them and to show them off. So, therefore, I want to do something like a industrial building. More or less just like a regular square building, just from these bricks, these red bricks, with huge windows windows inside. That is my idea, my imagination of one of these large fabric halls, industrial halls, something like that. And I really want to build that. And because of that, I decided to put down a little color palette. And this is the color palette I came up with. It has to be bricks. It is always bricks. So, no matter what we do, we have to do it with bricks. And these are the brick textures I can stand the most. Let's see. Connected plane here. Remove this for now. This was just meant to be struts for additional stability, something like that. So these are the blocks I want to go with. And the most likely block is this one. It's the most obvious block. It's the most obvious choice. And I think at least it is the best one when it comes to the theme of it. Oh, we can't pick out. I would have liked to have this half the size to pick out the white lines. You know what I mean? To bring them one in like this here. So we can have an actual texture. Man, that would have been awesome. I mean, I could actually try to build this by hand. Ooh, but can you imagine the kind of work that would be? Man, I can, and I don't want to do it. Although, maybe like this, just do it like this. It has still quite a bit of texture. Quite good, actually. And then we can... is this... Nope. We need... Where is it? Here. Draw region. Yeah. This was gone. Okay, good. So, we could actually try to do something like that. Oh, here's more missing. What did I do? Okay, I did something wrong, I think. No, that is good. Okay, good. So, we can actually produce a block with more texture. Although, compared to a large building, a really large building, at least this high, maybe that would cause a little bit of lag. I don't know. But this here would be easily duplicated with a design from Chisel, like I did this here. So, that would be really easy. Maybe I actually do it that way. It looks kind of good. But this is what I've came up with so far. So the blocks are more or less clear. I want to have the red brick. That is essential because that is the main theme of the building. That is what my imagination of one of those fabric halls look like, or industrial whatevers. So that must be. And then the floor. I looked at quite a few pictures and the floor is never something like this here. It is absolutely never. It is every single time either a polished floor, like polished concrete, or just concrete. I think this is because it has to be really durable. When something drops on it, imagine a large machinery part or something, it can't crack. So it is a very cheap, a very hard surface for a floor. And I like this here the most. The concrete from Immersive Engineering and from Railcraft. And I think we will do yours. Those here from Advanced Rocketry are too much like sand. And I don't like them because of it. And the concrete tiles are actually pretty nice. But I think only for accents. To highlight different parts in the floor, for example. Good. This is what I came up with. As I said, this here, I actually have no clue what they are called. T-Träger is the German word for it, because it has a T. And in this case, a double T. So these here are structural parts inside the building that is holding middle walls, for example, stuff like that. Even maybe as pillars in the middle of it. We have to see how it pans. But this is the theme I came up with. Now I want to lay out the basic facade from the front, what I imagine that could look like, and then I will show you in a second. All right, so here is what I came up with so far. Ignore the windows, they are mainly for showing what they're supposed to be. I will most likely design them by hand because I can't really find any sort of window that I would like in there. So they will get chiseled most likely. Maybe something like this here with a thick grid. but I am actually not the big fan of that. So I will most likely chisel those. If I can come up with something. These here, these struts or pillars or whatever you want to call it, will be way slimmer in the end and not a big block like this. And they will even maybe be of a different material. I haven't decided yet. But this is what the facade looks like. This top part here is just for show. It's just like a shield. The actual roof would go here behind it. Now I can't really show. This will even be a little bit different, most likely. And I have not decided what I will make the roof of. I would love those, but the angle is way too steep for what I would like. So the actual roof must be way, way, way flatter. So this here is the most top point of the roof, I think, something like that. And then it will decline slowly, like this, for example. Most likely even slower, because now we are here at the window already. But something along those lines. This will be most likely the roof. Slightly different, maybe. I did three somewhere? Yes, right here. Good. So something like that. That will be the roof. Can we show? Can we actually... Oh, yes, we can. Okay, good. Something like that. And not made out of a brick, but of something like this here. And this material, so this one here, I like the least. And this is also supposed to be steel, but it doesn't look that good. It is either this one or this one. This is either steel or dark steel. Supposedly this here is dark steel, I think. Because it's darker. we have to think about that. So there will be a roof like this here, all over this little overhang here, this part here. And then we have a big entrance like this here. This is just architecture block, but I like it so much. That is one of the most important mods, I think, when it comes to building. Because, man, actual round things make things so much better. I love it. Good. Then we have here this... Oh man, that's rather big, isn't it? Yeah, I like it. Maybe one block further out, like this here. Up to here, maybe. The outer wall. We have to see. It's already quite big. Maybe not. I don't want to go too far with it. No. I have to decide, but something along those lines. And then it will come, I think, all the way to here. Yeah, I actually want to have it that big until it touches or almost touches. Now I think I will bring it all the way back until it goes here, until it touches the mountain. And maybe even carve the mountain a little bit off. Well, let's see, where does it go? You know what? Here, this here behind is really, really beautiful. Maybe I will shear this whole mountain. I actually think that I will exactly do that. And bring this giant hall thingy, fabric industrial building, all the way to something like here. And then we have a nice overhang there in the back. Maybe do a separate building for energy production with diesel generators, stuff like that, maybe. Okay, I think I can see that. I can see that. This is, by the way, wrong. Oh, whoa. Man, the pickaxe is so good. It is actually way too good. Here. This must be the wall then. And the same on this side. Little coffee burp. That is not a brick. That is a brick. Thank you very much. Good. Something like that. Of course, it is rather uninteresting from the inside. We have to do something about that as well. Like struts, the ceiling as well. There has to be these thingies here. Going all through, starting here in the middle or something. Maybe here. Like that. So we have them all the way through. So we have actual structure. Not that we need it, you know. Just for makeshift and imagination. But I really like that. And I will try to get the building done a little bit further. And then I will show you what I came up with. Okay. I found a way to get rid of the mountain. And the really fun one. Yay! This is not the most efficient way in the world, but I will use it. Alright, so here is a quick update. And it is an update in two ways. First of all, I'm now recording from a new computer. I hope you can't tell by the difference in quality or something. But I am not longer recording on my Mac. I'm now recording on a brand new Windows PC. And the Mac is now dedicated to rendering and editing videos and stuff. That was the first little update. Second update. So this is what the building looks so far. You can see over there, I got rid of a little bit of the mountain. You saw me using the Ender Ender bomb or something like that. So we used that to get rid of a little bit. And the rest, I just used the pick. And I think that might even be faster. But when we look through here, you can see somewhere over there, there's the end. So we are, I think, not even halfway through. And we want to see all the way through to the other side. So this is what the building looked like so far. I had to bring it up one block, aka get rid of the lower row and add another row to the top, because we have no floor yet. And this here, what you see here, is actually the ceiling of the floor below. So we can't actually get rid of that. Therefore, we need to bring it one block up. Oh, this is also wrong, I think. Oh yeah, and I got rid of the arch. We have to install that back again later, but I was thinking about windows, and these are now windows that are chiseled. These here are a little bit smaller. It's just lead and blue glass, and I thought that might actually look pretty good together. The glass is supposed to be rather thick because it is meant to be an industrial building, not some finicky stuff right in there, so the glass can't get smashed when machinery is getting, to work. So, but I don't know if you know about this. This is a chisel, a positive chisel design. You have chisel designs inside chisels and bits. Let me get rid of a few things here. Not that. And grab a fresh one so I can actually... Oh, no, I don't need to. Can use this one here. Good. Get rid of it. And when you have an empty chisel design, you can click on a chiseled block and it will copy that complete block, lay, chisel, whatever, to this piece of paper. And then you can use your trusty old alt menu and see what we can do with it. So you can replace a block, you can add to something, you can place something, or you can impose into something. That are the options. And right now, when I try to place it, you can see I can't do it because I am running out of chisel bits. We have lead black here, back in the cap, in the bag, quite a bit actually, but not glass. Therefore, I place actually glass, the glass blocks I want to have the chisels in, and then use impose. I think impose. Nope, that was wrong. Replace. And then we replace the blog we have with the actual design. That way, the design makes use of the glass we actually placed. And the rest is, of course, just what we have in the bag. And when we run out of lead, we will do exactly the same just with lead blocks. I can show you right here. Do exactly the same, boop, just with lead. You will end up all with the correct block. And now we are we have too much glass again. Then we select placement again. We have both plenty in the in our bag. And then we can place again until we run out of bits. And then we can just place blocks and replace it with that. And that way you never have to chisel any actual blocks. If you do it another way, you can just place the glass and the lead blocks and chisel them to bits and use the bits to build the glass windows. But that way you have an additional work step. And this way we can avoid it. Whoop. So for the flooring, we have, as I said, two options. This here is the immersive engineering concrete. And then we have this here, the lighter ones from Railcraft. And I think they can both work. It's just a matter of if we want to have it brighter or darker. Considering the machines from Immersive Engineering, I think the brighter floor would be better. Yeah, I actually don't know. The brighter floor, I think, looks better. But the texture, man, I don't know. I like this texture way more. So, what should we do? I think I will leave it for now, and we can decide later. Sounds good? Good. Well, yeah. This is not a time jump or something like that. Yep. You actually see exactly what is happening here. The game crashed. And like big time. So I had to revert everything that I recorded so far on the new computer, because that save game got corrupted. And admittedly, it is completely my fault. Yeah, I decided that I want to give the actual... my inventory is completely full. The actual version of Chisels and Bits a chance to shine. So I installed the latest version, the most current one, the most, you know what I mean. Yeah, and after that, my game file got corrupted, and because I am who I am, I did not make a backup beforehand. Usually I always do that. Every single time. This time, not so much. So, we are back to where we left off. And I recorded... I didn't record. I put more work in. About 6 hours more work. Nah, maybe four. 4 hours. 4 hours more work. The complete thing was done. The complete mountain was gone. Up to here. The complete thing. Look at that. That was all gone. Everything. The building was completely finished. Well, it was not completely finished, but the windows looked very awesome. You saw that already. That is all gone. I had a roof. All gone. And that is, yeah, I think it is laughter of deniance or something like that. So I have to redo all of it. A lot of that stuff was just figuring out how I want to have it. So I think it will be easier to rebuild than to actually build it. But it has to be done. So I will put in a few hours of work and we will see us again with some progress later. Very, very much later. All right. So I got back to the point where I headed before, and I changed a few things. Now, first of all, these corner pieces here, these little corner pieces, I had them removed in the previous build, and now I decided to let it in. I think it gives a little bit more depth. And the outside is now also carved out like this. So we have a continuous window theme, so to speak. We didn't do this. Okay, later. But so far, so good. I have it back to where I had it before. A few things have changed. First of all, the original building was even numbers on the inside. And you know, we never want to do that in Minecraft. Even if Microsoft or Mojang tries to force us in that direction with this stupid new terracotta block. We won't obey. Good. So I have it back to the state it was before. I am not entirely sure if I want to keep the middle window the way I have it right now, because it is the same throughout all the windows except the little ones, which has the smaller window parts in it. And maybe I want to change that. I'm not entirely sure. I like those even more than those. Maybe I will change those. not sure. So, I have it back to the point where I had it before. I even added this roof now, this time. So we have this little four roof here. And we have a proper roof installed here. It is not the most beautiful in the world. Most beautiful roof in the world. Stop soloing words. But it is functional and it is supposed to be an industrial building. So it doesn't have to be the most interesting design-wise roof in the world. That is not the case of this building. We have to make it interesting by other means. For example, by the second layer, by the second floor I want to add. But this will not happen today. The outside kind of looks strange. And I still have to remove this bulk of a mountain here. I'm not entirely sure how I want to do it. The last time I used a combination of my pickaxe and the ender bombs. And I added, actually, vein miner. Now I am able to vein mine the blocks. And that way, it is rather... Come on. It is rather easy to reach the other end, which just now happened. Right? With vein miner... I'm so hungry. With vein miner, that is actually pretty easy to do. But on the other hand, you get this real straight look because the blocks get removed in the rectangle. And we don't want to have that. Oh, this is not vein minerable or something. Yeah, so I have to think about how I want to do that. Something happened. Okay, that was just Discord mute. I think... and all the blocks. I have decided. Because it is done already. Oh, man. But besides that... Get down. Thank you. I think the more detailed work, I will actually use inventory again. the ring of magnetization, or it's not the ring, it's the actual magnet around our neck. It's pretty awesome. The blocks follow us around everywhere. Okay, so I think this is all. Oh, let me sleep. This is all I want to do for today. The episode is already more than long enough, and I spent now the third day in a row just on this building. And I don't want to anymore. We have to add light, of course. There's barely any light in here. Oh, maybe even... You know what? We can have this... I actually don't know what it's called. Overlight something? It would be called in German that way. Huge windows here. So light can actually come from the top. Instead of just this dark roof. That is a pretty awesome idea. And I will try that. Oh man, the shadows. And it's so lovely. Let me know what you think of the building. And we will continue maybe in the next episode. Maybe I can force myself to go back to bees. That is still a big plan, a big thing of my work plan. So we will have to see what we do next. But I will most likely at least install a second floor. And I will try to install the windows in the roof. And then we will see what we do next time. Take care of yourself, guys, and rock on.